This week on Jon Thelen's Destination Fish, we break down how to catch walleyes when poor weather conditions and a bug hatch catch up with us on the same day. Then it's a midsummer morning on glass calm waters catching bluegills one after another. Jon Thelen's Destination Fish is brought to you by Lindy Fishing Tackle and Alumacraft Boats. Got him. Fish barely took it down. Just grabbed it and swam with it. I was actually watching the float move and barely go down as he swam. That's cool. That's the thing about slip float fishing that is so great is the ability to put a bait right in front of a fish's mouth and give him an opportunity, good walleye to start. Give him an opportunity to look at it, stare at it, think about it. And even if he's not super aggressive, in this fish, he wasn't real aggressive. And I'll tell you how I know that. He barely took the float down. He just took it down a little bit. That walleye right there barely hung it down. You can see where he's hooked. I mean, he didn't eat it real deep either. He just grabbed it and kind of hung onto it and swam with it. Just not in that super aggressive mode yet. But I'll tell you what, that fish right there, what a great way to start the day. Slip float fishing, when it comes down to it, I'll tell you what, I don't know that there is a more effective way to catch fish day in and day out based on the ability to give a fish time to decide to bite. He didn't just bite it the minute it hit the water. It sat for a little bit. He probably stared at it, thought about it, kicked it around a little bit. And next thing you know, he finally says, okay, I'll grab it. But he wasn't super aggressive. He just kind of swam with it. We're going to talk about slip float fishing today. It's one of my favorite ways to fish. There's no secret about that. I've always said slip float fishing is a really effective way to catch fish no matter where you go. But there's a few tips and tricks to it that we're going to share today. They're gonna help you catch a few more fish next time out. So I just went ahead and reeled to the boat just to see if I can make him bite, and he bit right at the back of the boat. Oh yeah, good walleye. Right at the back of the boat. These fish are so lethargic this morning though. I'll tell you, they're just not moving. And there's, I mean, it's an east wind. We're dealing with a cold front. It's just part of it. I mean, it's just fishing. But I'll tell you what, great walleye, perfect fish. First fish this morning, I was fishing a leech and the wind was blowing harder. So I was fishing a wobble bobber. Couple changes though. The wind has laid down a little bit. I've changed location. But because I've gotten a little bit out of the wind here, I've switched over to a Thil Pro Series float, okay? The yellow is just easy for me to see, and I didn't need to cast with the distance. Obviously on this fish right here, I just had to drop it in his face. But here's the thing, if I was still out in the wind, I'm gonna throw that wobble bobber because that wobble bobber casts a lot further than what I can throw this Pro Series. Then I'm running a single split shot. I talk about this a lot. If you run two split shot, when you cast, you take the chance on that line getting going like this and getting twisted up. So I run a single. And then down below it, I'm running a 16th ounce Lindy Live bait jig, but I want you to see one of the biggest changes I made. The water temps are already 74 degrees, and I've seen fish that I haven't been able to make bite since that first one. But I switched over to a crawler. I just hung a half a crawler on there. I pinched it off right down below the collar, and you know what? That fish came railing up and hit it. So you know what? Sometimes you just gotta make a bunch of changes, okay? Whether it be location, bait, color, whatever it is. But when you get in a situation like this where fishing's just tough, that east wind, that cold air, go ahead and just make some wholesale changes. Don't be as afraid of the big change on days like today.
Upgrade your fishing game with the 2024 Alumacraft Multi-Species Fishing Boat. Loaded with features like large aerated live wells, ample rod storage, large front casting decks, and the exclusive double-plated 2XB hull. This series delivers on performance and all-day comfort, making it a must for anglers who demand excellence. Contact your Alumacraft dealer to pre-order your 2024 boat and take your fishing adventure to the next level. Third-generation family-owned business that has proudly served the Northland for over 60 years. We carry products that cater to the communities surrounding our stores. We service what we sell, and we can equip you with everything you need for your next outdoor adventure. We are family. We are L&M Fleet Supply.
Gallus Marine in Wisconsin Rapids has everything you need to get your family out on the water this summer. New and used boat sales include top brands like Alumacraft boats and Berkshire pontoons, powered by Yamaha outboards. The parts and service departments will keep you up and running all summer long. Whether you're looking for a Yamaha-powered fishing boat, ski boat, or a pontoon, Gallus Marine has you covered, and when fall arrives, they'll be there to handle your winterization needs. Stop in and see them at their convenient Central Wisconsin location or look them up at gallusmarine.com.
This fight is between you and the fish. The lake may get unruly, but our motors quiet the noise. And now that the best trolling motors ever made are even better, we'll lead the charge. So you can focus on getting them to bite whenever and wherever the fight takes you. With Minn Kota, you're free to fish on any front.
Quick, right back down again. That's the pattern. I just missed it this morning. It took me time to work my way through it. This is the part of fishing that I'm gonna tell you still fires me up. This is the part of fishing that I just love from a standpoint of the fun of figuring something out that quite frankly fooled me this morning. But you know what? We weren't on the right thing. Now we are. Now we are, look at that. Now we are. That is cool stuff. So, first tip I would give you from this morning is this. When fish are flat on the bottom, set your depth deeper, okay? Be 6 inches off the bottom. Here now, I'm gonna tell you something. Here it's a big change. Look at that, what a pretty fish. Dinner fish right there. What a cool thing though, to run across this and be able to tell you, here's the change. The change that we're making now is I'm fishing right below the bug hatch. Okay, so this bug hatch is happening halfway down the water column, and I'm telling you, it's thick. So what I'm doing is I'm setting about a foot and a half above the bottom so that I'm just below the bug hatch. These fish are all sitting below the bugs, okay? I can't necessarily see them on my sonar. Every now and then I'm seeing one on my Mega Live, but it's so cluttered with all these bugs that I'm not getting a great look at it. But here's what I know. Those walleyes, they feed up and they're sitting down below those bugs right now. So what you wanna do is put your bait between the bugs and the walleye so that when he starts up, he sees your bait first. Because if you suspend that bait right in the middle of all that bug hatch, you're not gonna get bit. There's too many options. On his way up, he's gonna grab something else. But just putting your bait in between the bug hatch and where the fish are laying, I'll tell you what, he's gonna see you on his way up. Today we are fishing in relatively shallow water, 12 to 14 feet off the edge of shoreline points. Water temps have warmed to 74 degrees with air temps rising through the high 70s as clouds and showers give way to sunny skies. We are tipping 1/16th ounce Lindy Life bait jigs in chartreuse and orange with crawlers below Phil Pro Series XXL floats and casting to pods of bugs we are finding with the Humminbird Mega Live unit. I know everybody gets really hung up on being able to see fish with these Humminbird Mega Live units. Let me tell you something. Today, it's serving a whole different purpose for me. I'm into shallow enough water with all these bugs now And there is so much clutter in here that picking out fish on it is really hard because there is so much going on. But let me tell you something, I'm catching fish because of it, and I want to explain to you why. I'm using it to see where the hatches are around the boat. When I turn it to the back here, you can see there's a good hatch right there. So I can angle right back there and know that 30 feet back behind the boat, I can throw to a really good hatch and know there's probably walleyes below it. I'm doing the same thing all the way around the boat. There's a clear spot right there. I'm not gonna throw over there. Keep turning it. There's a good hatch right there. So you know what? There are just so many ways that this mega live can help you catch fish. Got him. Just a case of a little bit of moving around. I just sliding the boat a little bit. You know, it's one of the coolest things I'll tell you is that jog feature enables you to just move in those small little increments. Minn Kota really nailed it with spot lock and the jog deal, because you can move just little bits at a time like this. And I'll tell you what, it makes it so you can really pick water apart. That's a walleye, good fish. Look at that, great way to wrap it up. I'll tell you what a fun day once we dialed this in. Holy smokes, you know, this is one of those days you get to see on TV a little bit more of the process, because sometimes we just don't have all the time it takes to show you that whole process that sometimes you have to go through to get that done. But today you got to see it. I started on mid-range stuff where I thought the fish should be. No reason they shouldn't have been there, but they weren't. Got one, went out deeper, never touched a fish. You know, crazy as that sounds, at this time of the year, you always feel like that progression is out, but it's not always the case. Came back in here shallow, got in where these bugs are hatching, where all the minnows are, and there you go. That's a great day of fishing.
Hi, this is Greg from Outdoors Again in Baudette, Minnesota. I'd like to personally invite you to stop in and visit us here at Outdoors Again, where we carry the largest selection of fishing tackle, bait, firearms, and ammo in northern Minnesota. We are the home of the Jig Buffet. We are conveniently located on Highway 11 in downtown Baudette with plenty of parking to accommodate boats, wheelhouses, and trailers. We are your one-stop shop for all of your outdoor needs, including bait, tackle, firearms, ammo, and much, much more. We look forward to seeing you here at Outdoors Again.
This is the place. Warner's Dock in New Richmond, Wisconsin is the place to find your new Suzuki-powered fishing boat or pontoon. The new redesigned show floor at Warner's Dock is home to a large inventory of pontoons and fishing boats from various manufacturers, as well as a complete lineup of Suzuki outboards. The service and parts department have you covered from beginning to end, including off-season storage solutions. Stop in and see the team at Warner's Dock for all your boating needs. This is the place.
Take your trolling game to the next level with the all-new Trollmaster Pro Angler. The Pro Angler pairs with your current Trollmaster system or can be purchased as an all-inclusive kit while still compatible with Panther Electrosteer models. New features include increased battery capacity to keep you fishing longer and Strike Mode, a built-in function that increases your speed in short bursts every 2, 4, or 6 minutes to trigger more strikes. Up your trolling game and catch more big fish with the all-new Trollmaster Pro Angler.
Dan's Southside Marine in Bloomington, Minnesota is one of the largest Suzuki outboard dealers in the country. Pair that power up with a brand new Alumacraft boat, you have the ultimate package. Dan's carries an extensive inventory of Suzuki-powered Alumacraft boats, meaning you will find the model that fits your family and be on the water this spring. Dan's also offers an experienced service staff and a large parts and accessories department that is sure to have everything you need. Sales, service, parts, winterization, and storage, Dan's Southside Marine does it all.
Whether you crank it, jig it, flip it, slow roll, or troll. Stryker Technical Apparel gives you the freedom and confidence to fish, no matter your style, no matter the weather. Because with Stryker, when it's on, it's on.
Next up, we take the kids fishing. Nick LeCann and I, along with two of his boys, Baron and Corbin, track down midsummer bluegills that have left the shoreline and taken up residence on an offshore hump. Jon Thielen's Destination Fish is brought to you by Thill Floats and Alumacraft Boats. There he goes, he already bit it.
Baron.
Flip that bail over. There we go, just watch him. He'll bite it again. There he goes, get him.
Keep the rod tip up. What are you supposed to say? Fish on.
Ooh, good gilly. Lift him right up over here. Look at that. Hoist him right in here, bud. Oh. So let me ask you a question. What could be better than starting a fishing trip when you throw one line in and show everybody what you're gonna do and you get a good gill to start? Look at that. Good fish, buddy. That doesn't count for the buck till everybody's in the water. This is gonna be a fun day. I'm gonna fish with Nick LeCann and his kids, Baron and Corbin. What we're gonna do today is we're gonna do what I think is way, way, way overlooked and people aren't doing enough of, and that's just going fishing for fun, bending rods, catching panfish, and most importantly, getting the kids out on the water. And that's what Nick and I are gonna talk a lot about today, because when it comes down to it, this right here is some of the cleanest fun that you can give your kids. And that's a good start, right? Mm-hmm. Happy with that start?
Yeah.
All right.
Oop, and it's gone. What do you say? Fish on, or John doesn't know what's
good
going on back here.
Swing him back here, that's a nice one.
Look at that, he didn't get your minnow either.
Yeah, another good gill. Show you what we're using here real quick, because it's a simple little deal.
Are we still going to use a minnow?
Yep, we're going to still use a minnow. But in between the chaos, I want everybody to know. Oh, another fish. Swing him up here, another good one. You know what, we'll use that one. You guys can bait that one back up. 16th ounce Lindy Little Nipper. Pretty easy deal. Thill Pro Series float, just using one of the smaller sizes. All we're doing, we're fishing minnows today. It's midsummer. I know most of the time people think about crawlers for bluegills, but I'll tell you what, midsummer, they like minnows. And they'll eat a minnow just as fast as a crawler, and minnows keep your boat a little bit cleaner. Whole bunch of them under us. There goes one of them right there.
What do you
say? Didn't even get to the bottom.
Push on.
Double. Ooh, good gilly. Nice one. Swing them over. Look at this. Couple nice ones. Get them unhooked. There you go, Baron. You can get that one taken care of. You know, one of the things you want to do, and I just did it there. I told the boys to just hang on a minute. There you go. Because here's the thing. I lost the school, and what'll happen on these schools of fish is we're on a small little hump here, and you can see it on the graph, but here's the thing about it. The school of fish is not huge. It's just there's maybe thousands of fish in the school. They're just really, really tight together. And those fish, they stay close together because there's a lot of things that eat these fish when they're younger. So they learn to stay together in a school. And if that school moves, just creep the boat around until you find that school again, because that Minn Kota is going to allow you to do it nice and slow, and you're going to see them on your hummingbird. Get right back over the top of them, and that quick, these boys doubled as soon as we dropped back in. That's a good gilly anywhere you go. That's awesome. You know, this is another one of those things too that I'll tell you. Don't be afraid to let the kids do this. You know, we showed Baron this morning how to bait up, and I know sometimes it's so hard to be patient. There's a ton of fish here. You're in a hurry to get back in the water, but show them how to do it and take the time to teach them how to do it, to teach them this stuff and have the patience to let them do it. There he goes. Let it go. There he goes. Got him? Man, I'll tell you, when you get on a school of fish like this, I'll tell you a little bit about today's location, because it's not what most people would think. Bluegills, for the most part, when you get to midsummer like this, they slide out to structures that aren't those shoreline weeds. And I'll tell you, this is 12 to 13 feet deep, surrounded by deep water. And the key to this one is there's a little bit of weed growth on the bottom. But that's kind of stuff you're looking for, those first humps off of shore. You can see shore in the background here. We're close to shore. Those fish were in those shoreline weeds not too long ago, but those fish have now roamed out and they get on these little structures. So look for that stuff as you move on in the summer. Your bigger bluegills, your keeper size panfish, are always gonna move offshore and get into those secondary structures, those little humps. Lacan's Marine in Faribault, Minnesota offers everything you need to enjoy your time on the water with family and friends. Lacan specializes in Yamaha-powered Alumacraft boats, and you can bet they have the model and horsepower you are looking for in their extensive inventory. Lacan's also offers parts and accessories along with an experienced service department that will keep you on the water, and when fall arrives, they can handle your winterization and storage needs. Get out on the water this summer with a new Yamaha-powered Alumacraft boat from Lacan's Marine. Zippo Bay Resort is the premier resort on the south shore of Lake of the Woods. Spend the day on one of Zippo Bay's 6 30-foot charter boats or bring your own boat to explore the pristine waters of the Big Lake. Log cabins in various sizes have all the amenities, while clean and comfortable housekeeping cabins are also available. Spend a day at the pool and hot tub, play on the water toys, enjoy great food and drink in the lodge, and relax around the campfire in the evenings with family and friends. Make Zippo Bay Resort on Lake of the Woods your next summer getaway.
Today, anglers fish longer. Today, anglers fish harder. Today, anglers rely more than ever on their electronics. It all comes down to catching more fish. And today, anglers rely on Amped Outdoors lithium batteries, period.
This is your tackle. You use it to catch this, or this, or this. You also use this, and that, and these. This is your environment. So is this. You love it, live for it, but it will turn this into that. This is the Flambeau Z-Rust Max Tuftainer Series. These are fully infused with exclusive Z-Rust VCI anti-corrosion technology. This is a U.S. naval battleship. The same Z-Rust technology used here has been used on those. This is the next level of tackle management. Built to fish, built to last. What's your tackle worth?
We are L&M. We are a third-generation family-owned business that has proudly served the Northland for over 60 years. We carry products that cater to the communities surrounding our stores. We service what we sell, and we can equip you with everything you need for your next outdoor adventure. We are family. We are L&M Fleet Supply.
There you go, Bernie.
He's on fire back here now. Good one. Nice fish. Swing him over here.
Look at him.
You know, we're in the Big Dad boat today. You know, this is the boat that I use for pretty much everything. But I'll tell you, one of the neatest things about Alumacraft is the lineup of boats makes it so that no matter what kind of fishing you want to do, I mean, you can do it. Nick has those boats in stock every single day down at Lacan's.
All kinds of stuff to choose from. Tiller boats. We do a lot of tiller boats. It's a big seller for us. Really good area for the rivers and the main lakes for different types of fishing. A lot of guys from Iowa come up and buy tiller boats. But a lot of family boats, a single consoles, full windshields. Anything from a 14-foot to a 21-foot boat. A lot of different options.
Yeah, a lot of different ways to get your kids into fishing and still be able to get out with the guys or whatever it may be that you want to do. I'll tell you, Alumacraft's always just made a great boat. They're versatile. Some of these launches on some of these lakes I fish, you would never get into with a big, heavy fiberglass boat, but with an aluminum boat like these Alumacrafts, you can get into some of these lakes that I'll tell you what, have fishing like this. One of the things that happens and what I'm gonna do here is just real quick, I might lift everything a little bit. And the reason for that is we're getting on in the morning just a little bit now. And what always happens with these bluegills, happens with crappies too. On a day like today, when you got sunshine, clear skies, clear water, it's bright, it's its brightest point that you're ever gonna have. These fish will lift as the day goes on and you gotta adjust. So this morning when we got here, I set up right on the bottom. And what I'm doing now is we're working our way up. Now a lot of these fish I'm seeing are 3-4 feet up. swim.
There you go. There you
go. Look at that. How quick did that little change matter, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Fish are just lifting. When they lift, you just want to go up a little higher. You know, it's really amazing too. Nice fish. As you can see this happening on that hummingbird. I mean, we're hovering right over these fish and I'm just watching these fish get higher and higher in the column. And it's as simple as, yep, you're all ready to go. Go right back in. Simple as just sliding that slip knot just a little bit, going a couple feet higher, and now all of a sudden, look at this. They're catching them like crazy again after a little bit of a lull.
Lift your rod tip up. There you go. Good job.
Good fish. Good job. Yeah, that's a great fish.
Whoa, there it is.
There it is. Got him?
Yeah. Oh.
Ooh.
Frisky one.
Good job, buddy.
Swing it over to Johnny.
Swing him over. Look at that. That's pretty cool, man. We have caught big fish. We've caught medium-sized fish. We've caught small fish. What a fun day. Tell you what, before we go today, I want to take a quick minute and have Nick tell you a little bit about his great dealership, because if you're itching to get the family out on the water and do this, this is easy to do, and Nick can take care of the first step for you.
Yeah, it's a great thing that we have going down at Placans Marine. We have pretty much everything a guy could ask for between pontoons, sea-doos. We've got Alumacraft fishing boats, Vexus fishing boats, and we have a full complimentary sales staff, parts and service. So we got basically everything that a customer needs.
Yeah, and at the end of the day, these guys will also take care of your winterization for you. I mean, everything they sell, they service. So you're a one-stop shop to take care of everything for everybody. And then, you know, I look at one of the things I think is the biggest deal when I walk into Lacan's is the huge selection of boats right there on the show floor. If somebody's looking for a new boat, you guys got everything to show them right there.
Lots of colors and lots of options, and that's what people want to see.
Yeah. It's one of the things I've kidded about before. When you go to Lacan's, it's not, hey, do you have this model in stock? You know what it is? What color would you like? Because these guys have it. I'll tell you what, fun day of fishing. Just can't beat it. Get some kids out on the water. This year was one of the best days I've had fishing all year as far as the fun factor goes. Make sure to tune in next week. We'll have another great episode of Jon Thelen's Destination Fish. Closed captioning for Jon Thelen's Destination Fish is brought to you by Formula Propeller.